Hello, everybody. We are back here, and welcome to the streaming later than normal because Xfinity is trash and we had to get our internet reset up stream. Yeah, we're going with that. But anyway, we're going to jump over to Rancho, and we're going to grind the great one today. Hopefully, we can end up getting it. That'd be amazing. Once I'm not grinding animals when you start. Yeah, Johnny, how's it going? How's everybody doing? Cantor on Cisco, Thomas plays, Layton, Cobb, Zyphon, Benjamin, Xander, Bass Slayer, Slate, Dark, Leroy, MDTV, how's everybody doing? Hey, Global KK, Freddy, hey, Syro, hopefully you're all doing good today. Gotta love it when you have internet struggles and have to stream later because of it. It's a fantastic thing. But I think we're good, so it should be good for the rest of the day, thankfully. Let's get our other 308. That way we can double 308 again like we typically do. Oh, wrong one. There we go. And then drop that in there. Drop that there. And Hyperion. Perfect. All right, we're ready to go. There's our map as we start. I'm doing pretty good, Bass Slayer. Doing pretty good. Jeez, Johnny, that's wild. Played since the Great One came out? Nice, Blake. That's about how long I've been doing YouTube, actually. I started a little bit before the Great One was first released. Well, hello there. I see you guys just like to pop into render. Don't see anything too crazy. We just got something there. It popped up for a second, but no prompt to spot it again. And then we just had a call back here. Oh. Well, I despise having this zone right here, so we'll probably have to take those out soon. They can't keep up. Jeez, Johnny. Just wrecking those spawns. Okay, that is the wrong scope. We want the Argus on this one. There we go. I think I got it set up. Also, how's the mic sounding today, guys? I did some more tweaking to it once again. I can never, like, get the exact sound that I want out of it, so I've been changing it quite a bit to try and get the perfect sound, and I want to know, what do you guys think of it? Does it sound too deep? Does it sound not deep enough? Does it sound low quality, high quality, good, bad? What do you guys think? All right, awesome. Glad you guys are liking how it's sounding. Once I get my big desk, then I'll have like a better setup, but right now I kind of have the mic off to the side, so like every time I look over to the left at my chat, I'm like looking away from the mic so it doesn't pick up my voice quite as loud. You guys could probably tell a little bit of dip in volume right here whenever I turn over to read chat, and then when I look back at my game, it goes up a little bit in volume. So unfortunately it's not like an ideal setup, but it's only temporary until probably like first week of May, because that's when my desk is supposed to arrive. Thank you, Jaden. I appreciate that, man. That's very kind of you. Hey, David, I'm doing good, man. I'm doing pretty awesome. Just been having internet struggles as always, but we should be good for the day. I'm not sure, Thomas. It's already taken about 1,000 kills since our last one. My guess is it'll be a total of 2,000 kills, so I feel like we're halfway there. But you never know, the Great One has a way of just kind of taking you off guard and showing up at random times. They never know, maybe we'll get lucky and end up finding him sooner. Anything over there? Does not look like it. That's probably for you, Blake, because it's actually good on my end. On my end, it's actually looking pretty good. Have not dropped any frames yet, so it might be your Wi-Fi or your wireless carrier having a little bit of issues. So he should have at least killed two more. I don't know where they've ran off to, though. I know, Robert, we just started. Nice, Bluefish. Diamond gators are always fun. Oh, it has, Johnny? Jeez. That's crazy. That's quite a lot. What's my thoughts on the Mosin? It's a pretty good rifle. I feel like it's in a very, like, weird space, though. With it being a 3-7 rifle, it really doesn't get used as much as it used to, because there's other guns that fit the classes better. Like, most people go with the 243, their favorite 4-8 rifle, and then the 300 Magnum and the 22. So it makes it so the Mosin really doesn't get used too much, because it kind of throws off the whole, I guess, like, classes that you have in your loadout. I do think it's a good rifle, though. It's just, unfortunately, in a very weird spot. I didn't want to place a waypoint. I'm trying to fast travel. Hey, bro, how's it going, dude? You probably would, and then you'd shoot it thinking that it was a level 2. And then you'd be like, ah, man, why does this level 2 look so weird? That's exactly what would happen, and you know it. Oh no, Clash, that's unfortunate, man. That type of stuff happens, though. At least you have a great one, you know? Even if it did get messed up, at least you have a great one. Because that's more than some people are able to say. Oh, guess what, Brobra? I ended up opening up some Magic the Gathering packs earlier today, just for fun to see if I would get anything good, and I actually did end up getting a really good card. It's from the newest set, and apparently one of the cards I opened is like a $40 card out of, you know, just a regular booster pack. So that was kind of cool. My brother-in-law is super into Magic, so he was immediately able to, like, tell me what all of the cards were. And apparently I pulled a good one out of, like, 3 packs. Nice, Expo. That's awesome, dude. Congrats on the great one. Well, hello there, little dude. Oh my gosh, we barely saved that. We barely saved that shot. Yeah, I agree. Mosin should be a higher class range. I mean, 7.62x54R is a massive round. In real life, that's bigger than a 308. It's got more power than a 308. It definitely is in a very strange spot. To be honest, I don't even think it should be 4-8. I think it should be a 7-9 rifle. Or a 6-8 or 6-9. Honestly, a 6-9 rifle would be incredible. It could be the first 6-9 rifle if they were just to change it. Because I do agree with it being in a very weird class and also weird power level. It's weaker than what it should be. Yeah, no problem, Cornies. Of course, man. Of course, man. I'm always happy to make content for you guys. And it's always nice to see that it helps people out. And I appreciate the Discord boost. That is always super helpful to the server as well. Because the higher level the Discord server is, the more, like, perks it gives us. So I appreciate that, man. Nice, Ryland. Still going strong on my great one grind on Rancho, about 800 kills in. Nice C plays. Hopefully you'll get it soon. Hopefully your great one is right around the corner. What do we got over here? A doe. Come on, there's gotta be more than just one doe. Shot my first diamond lion today on my own map while tracking Gemsbok. Then later I shot my second diamond Cape Buffalo. Nice survey, that's awesome, man. Congratulations on those trophies. And boop! Poor doe. She just got smoked. Alright, we got time to reload. Then we'll take those out. Oh my gosh, I hit the buck through the doe's legs. I gotta say, that's probably one of the more impressive shots I've made the last month or two. And those were probably a couple of the worst. I mean, you have a couple good shots. Bound to have a couple bad ones to follow. Today I got a troll Cape Buffalo, later got a max score diamond Cape Buffalo. Nice sky guy, that's what I call redemption. That is what I call redemption, man. Eventually, you know, Call of the Wild just has a way of working out like that. You get screwed over by the scoring, you know, one or two times, and then you come back and get something crazy. Do you just shoot the bucks? No, I shoot the bucks and the does. How many have I killed on this grind? We're probably closing in on 1,000, if I were to take a guess. I'd have to go look at my my notepad that I have everything typed into. Sorry to hear that, Wesley. Hopefully you'll get better, man. Hopefully the streams will help you feel better, too. So is that why people just keep killing all the males on the maps to get bigger and better animals? Yeah, because, like, whenever you shoot something, it does come back as, like, the same gender or whatever. Like, you shoot a buck, you're gonna get a buck back. And most likely, they most times will come back at roughly the same size as the previous one, but there's also a chance that they can come back bigger or smaller. And so, yeah, the more you shoot, the more chances that one of them will come back bigger and be a diamond, or even have a chance of coming back as a rare. So yes, that is why people shoot a lot of animals on their maps, even if they're, like, not anything special. Because you do get a brand new deer or brand new animals every time you shoot one. Doubled up on Rio Grande turkeys, shot a diamond Rio Grande turkey. Nice, Jet, that's awesome. Roughly 1,000 kills into my game. Only 2 diamonds, but like 15 rares, one's a gold rare. Nice, Hampton, that's pretty good. That's honestly a really good ratio. So something that a lot of people, I think, mistake for what it's supposed to be is a lot of people think that you're supposed to get a diamond every 100 kills, roughly. But in reality, it's more of like you average a diamond or a rare every 100-ish kills. So you're actually doing pretty good. You're actually doing really good for only having 1,000 kills. I'd say that is pretty nice. Where are these deer? Where did I shoot these other ones? We got a couple over there, but I swear I shot at least one more buck over here. Do you see it, Hunter? Okay, Hunter sees it. Beautiful. Beautiful. I think this had to have been the first one we shot, right? This had to have been the first one. Nice, Carlson. That's awesome. That is awesome, dude. Congratulations. Yeah, true. Mountain lions are a bit different. And I think that's to balance out the fact that they are, for the most part, an animal that's just in, like, solo zones or, like, 2 or 3 in a zone. I do feel like some of those species that there's less of them in a zone, they kind of have a higher chance of making diamond. Or higher chance of being a max level. I've noticed the same with bobcats. Bobcats seem to do roughly the same thing. Yeah, it's pretty good, Mr. Amazing. That's actually really good. No, we're out of shots. But we actually got him. Wow. Okay, that was actually vitals. Wow. That's not what I expected. I could have swore that was a pretty bad shot, but we must have, like, hit through the, like, hind quarter or something and got into liver? I don't know. That was a weird angle to get a vital hit. Very weird angle to get vitals. I'm really curious to see what we hit here. Nice, Aiden. That's awesome, dude. And, huh. I guess we caught him on the jump. I mean, I'll take it. Saw Cape Buffalo get sent into orbit yesterday. I've seen that happen a couple times to animals. Not Cape Buffalo in particular, but I have seen it happen to a few different animals. It is pretty hilarious when it happens. Pretty much, Zyphon, pretty much. How do you know how many kills you are into your grind? I just keep track of it manually. I write it down after every time I grind. Like the estimated amount of deer that I shot in that grinding session. And then over time it just will, you know, keep a total of everything you've killed. Obviously you have to do the math yourself, but that is about the only way that you can do it. That almost looks like a piebald doe, but I can't quite tell. A lot of deer over there, though. Lots of deer there. Nice, Jeff, that's awesome. Yeah, Bluefish, it's just deer in general. The thing is, like, my first, like, 6,000 kills were all bucks. And then I changed up my grinding method. And so after that, it was bucks and does. But I definitely kill more bucks than I do does. When you mess up a great one, it turns into a gold. I'm going to be taking my next great one with the 6.5, Matthew. I'm going to try a long-range 6.5 shot. Nice, not clips. Just found a trash albino whitetail, 155 max. That is a small male. Gotta love getting those. I've had quite a few of those fence rack rares. It's always disappointing when you see those. No fair, you were gonna do that? Yeah, but I was gonna do it first, Johnny. Haha. Alright, let's get these down. Long range sniper time. Imagine that was the great one. Imagine that was also the great one. But they're not. We're not that lucky. We may be lucky, but not double great one lucky. My gosh, there's so many deer on that side. It looks like just all of our deer went to this side of the lake. That's crazy. Alright, let's try this. Also a doe behind him. It's a big buck right there. Very, very big deer. And none of these spooked off, so we can actually reload. Yours did that too? It seems like they kind of go through phases of like being on one side of the lake and then moving to the other and then moving back. Call of the Wild's deer can be very odd at times. Well, that didn't work. You know, maybe we can get a shot off. Oh my gosh, if that was vitals. It wasn't, but if it was, that would have been insane. Please. Please tell me one of those hit. We still have some over there, though. Is it diamond potential? Probably not. It didn't have the correct antlers to be a diamond potential. It had like a good score estimate, but the actual antlers were not a diamond rack. All right, well, we have a lot of deer down. We should probably go get them. Let's just check over here first. Okay, no deer on that side. Can I click on the tent? There we go. It really depends, Jordan. If it's within the first month after a big update, I typically play like 7 to 10 hours a day. But that's just because of like a new update, so there's lots of content to cover. Right now, I'm only playing like probably 4 hours a day. Because I do a couple hours of streaming and then a couple hours of video. And that's just on average. Wow, we actually connected a shot on that guy. That's crazy. I probably shouldn't have 0 to 300. That was a bad idea. Okay, we got a vitals. If that thing does not die, I'd be very surprised. All right, later, Ben. Thanks for dropping in, dude. Hey, Kevin. Oh, I am deleting my zones, Andrew. It's part of my grinding method for Rancho. On Rancho, I use a very different grinding method than what I would use on other maps. The thing about Whitetail on Rancho is no matter how many times I delete my zones, they always come back to the same lake. Now, their zone might move to a different part of the lake than where I shot them from, but they always seem to come back to the same lake that I killed them at. So, I don't really have to worry about deleting zones on Rancho. Now, this is partially just because I only use a few lakes. I don't use every lake on the map. If you were to use every lake, it would definitely throw things off more, but I just hunt these three main lakes, and then this tiny one here, and this tiny one up here. And because I hunt so few lakes, and it really doesn't affect my zones too much when I just blast everything. Now, I've tried this on other maps, and it does not work on other maps, but here on Rancho, it seems to work pretty well. Yeah, Expo, it is, I don't know. When I was trying to use the old methods of just shooting bucks, I found that a lot of my zones on Rancho just turned doe only. And that's why I started doing this one. Now, I have heard that there are some people that this method does not work for. I'm assuming that the people that it doesn't work for, they're probably doing something a little bit different than what I do. But just keep in mind, if you do things slightly different than what I'm doing, then it might not work correctly. That is something I have seen a few people say. So I just wanted to make sure you guys know that. It seems like there really is something to do with exactly how I do it. Seems like if you do things slightly different, like hunting all the lakes instead of just the ones that I hunt, it seems like it can throw it off to where they don't come back to the same areas that you previously found them at. How much cash do I make with this method? A lot. A lot, because you're shooting literally everything in sight. So it builds up the money very quickly. I'd say it's probably like 70 to 100,000 per stream. And that's for a 2-hour stream, obviously. If I'm doing shorter streams than my normal 2 hours, then obviously it's a little bit less money, but I'd say it's easily 70k plus. How did you get so much ammo? How long did it take? I mean, to be honest, just doing what I'm doing right now gets you this amount of ammo. Because when you think about it, one box of ammo is like, what, 800? And you shoot two deer and you've already paid for a box. And since we kill probably anywhere from 70 to... Actually, probably more than 70. I think it's probably at least 100 deer in a 2-hour period. You can see how the money comes back pretty quickly and you can afford lots of ammo. the other thing is I've spent probably 3,500 hours on the game, so I've had plenty of time to build up quite a bit of cash to purchase ammo and stuff like that. Where's the rest of these? Is that our dog? What are you doing, Hunter? You just chilling up there, man? Jeez. Yeah, mountain lions are a crazy amount of money. Oh, how long did it take to buy it? Gotcha. It was probably like 5 minutes of just straight spamming enter left click, enter left click, enter left click. Because for those of you that didn't know, you can just, you can click on the buy thing and then use enter to confirm it if you're on PC. I'll have to show you guys soon, because it does speed up the process quite a bit of purchasing. Well, I did have more ammo at Expo. I think I had like 3,000 when I bought it last, so I was talking about more for like 3,000. Not for the 1,200 that we currently have left. Yeah, pretty much, Johnny. That's what I've always found, is that I get asked a lot, like, how to make money in Call of the Wild and, like, what is some of the best ways. And though there is obviously certain species that make you money faster, if you're doing really any grind for any species, you'll make money. It just kind of comes along with it. But while we're thinking of it, let's buy 308 ammo. So yeah, you just click buy and then enter to confirm it. So then you just sit there and do this. So it really doesn't take too long to buy that much ammo. I would bluefish, but that would require me to move my hand across my keyboard, like, constantly. And also I'd get a million questions about, like, how are you confirming it without clicking on it? And so it'd be a whole thing. I don't feel like answering 10 million questions about why I can confirm a harvest without clicking on it. So I just opt not to use enter to confirm it. I've thought about, like, binding a key on my mouse to be an enter key. But, same thing there, I'd get too many questions about it. Yeah, you should probably buy some more then, Kevin. It's been a while since I've had 2 million siphon. I think the last time I had 2 million was just a few months into doing YouTube. Alright. There we go. This kind of work raises too many questions. It really does, Northern. That is just a part of being on YouTube, though. What map should I hunt? I have all of them. How about Mississippi Acres? Do some, like, field hunting. Hey, Slays, how's it going, dude? Welcome to the stream. Hey, Wild. How do you have so much money? 3,500 hours of grinding, pretty much. Well, I guess not all 3,500 hours was spent grinding, but considering I've got, let's see, over 12,000 whitetail kills and probably like 6 or 7,000 red deer kills, that alone makes more money than what I've currently got. Slays, welcome to the Scarecrow, man. Hope you enjoy the stay here. Enjoy the green name in chat, the special badge icon, all the awesome emotes, ability to use commands, access to private Discord channels, access to my private, or not private, access to my scrapped content on the channel. Really appreciate it. Been a few days since I've been able to stream properly, so I couldn't even say my own thing properly there. But thank you, Slays. Really appreciate that. Boop. How was that not a brain shot? No. He's gonna get away. Well, that went, that went less than perfect. Wait, where did we shoot the first one? How, was he really that far away? I guess he was. I didn't think he had got that far before we shot him. But I guess they were clear over here. Yeah, Johnny, for sure. You have a ridiculous amount of money from those mountain lions. Those things are such good cash, honestly. Such a good way to grind up money. Got a few does over there. What gun am I using? I'm currently using the 308 AR from the Modern Rifle Pack. I've got a question for you guys. Would you guys be... I know I've already had a few requests to do this. And I found some fun ways that I could introduce it to the channel, maybe, if you guys want to see it at least. I've had quite a few requests to do some, like, different modded Minecraft. Would you guys be interested in seeing a hunting mod on Minecraft? And possibly the Pokemon mod as well? I think that could be a lot of fun. And I was going through the different mod packs that they have for Minecraft, and there was a cool hunting one that looked like it would be fun. So I think that could be kind of a cool thing to do if you guys want to see it. Because I feel like most people at least know what Minecraft is. And most people have probably played it. So I feel like it would be something you guys would actually enjoy watching. And we could try a bunch of fun stuff with it as well. Hey Xander, how's it going? Pixelmon would be a great throwback. Oh, for sure, McLord, it definitely would. You know what's funny? When I was testing the mod out to actually see if we had set everything up properly for Pixelmon, literally the first Pokemon I caught was a shiny. no, Crystal, we have not got the great one. No great one today. But we're hoping to get it soon. Chipper Berman, thank you for the super chat, dude. Really appreciate the support. 8k kills, no great one. 53 diamonds, is it bad luck or a bug? Definitely bad luck. There's people that have gone way more kills without seeing one, so it's just unfortunately the bad RNG. But I appreciate the super chat, dude. Great to see you back in the stream. But yeah, it's definitely not a bug. As far as I know right now, there is no bugs relating to the Great One. I'm pretty sure all the Great One bugs have been fixed. So anything that's happening is unfortunately just bad luck. When should you use soft points? To be honest, most situations soft points aren't a good option. I mean, there's a couple times where soft points can be good, but in most cases, you want to use poly tips. How's the moving going? It's going great, James. We're finally finished unpacking stuff. We actually just finished cleaning stuff up the last couple days, and we're finally fully settled into this new place. Except for the fact that I'm still waiting for my desk and chair to arrive in the mail. Once those get here, then I'll be fully set up. It'll be nice. This new desk that I'm getting is actually going to be much nicer for setting up a streaming setup as well. I'm going to have a little bit more space than I'm used to, and I'll be able to put my microphone in a better location, which is great. Because right now my mic's in kind of an unfavorable position where it's kind of off to my right side. And if I look away from the mic, it doesn't pick everything up. And my voice ends up being a little bit quieter, like you guys can kind of hear right now. Not sure, SC. I don't know when they're going to have another sale. I would imagine next time they release an update, there will probably be some type of sale that goes with it. That's typically how they do it on PC, at least. I don't know about console. I'm not sure how they do the sales there. That's a big one. I think that's diamond potential. And that guy's big too. Wow, we got all the big bucks over here. Jeez. That is a lot of big deer. That is a lot of really big bucks. I can't even see all of them. They're all just hiding in that brush. Let's get them to move out, because that is a lot of big deer. This is the diamond potential kind of hidden right there. I don't think this guy has a chance. Wow, he's really weirdly hooked in, though. Okay, this is our guy. This is the diamond potential. Nice, we got both of them. And this guy's big too, but I don't think he's diamond potential, unfortunately. His rack isn't quite big enough, as far as I can tell. And I mean, we kind of messed him up, so it's not going to matter anyway. That's some good deer, though. That is some really good deer. Just get those down as well. Any more? Oh, that's not a shot I meant to take. Getting a little trigger happy here. Definitely going to make it. I think it will, too. It looks like it. They happen randomly? Gotcha. Yeah, I knew it wasn't the same as PC, because there's been so many times where, like, I tell my wife that there's a sale going on, and she's like, nope, nope, no sale on Xbox. Join to this chaos? Yes, West. You joined at the perfect time, though. I mean, diamond potential whitetail, and then a very strange-looking deer as well. Diamond ground. Yeah, we did get some diamond ground as well. Where am I? The United States. On Earth. In a solar system somewhere. Will I do another Trophy Lodge tour soon? It's only been a couple months since our last one, right? I think it's only been like 3 months since the last Trophy Lodge tour. Most likely we won't do another one until like June or July. I live in Oregon, Xander. In some cases, yes, Jason, but the problem is, you have to be perfectly broadside most of the time for a soft point to even make it to a lung. So in most cases, poly tips are more reliable. You don't have to worry about messing things up. Okay, this was the kind of hooked in one, I think. Yeah, this is the one that was hooked in really tight, and then like, yeah, it's an interesting deer. Not a diamond though, but that, wow, hold on. Look at that weight, though. I think this might have been the diamond rack, but it hooked in really tight. This actually might have been the diamond rack, but it just hooked in really tightly, so it didn't make it. Jeez, because yeah, if it had better tip-to-tip, that would be a big male. Not bad. Not bad. Yeah, pretty much, Johnny. Pretty much. It's looking good for me, Xyphon. Does anyone need a lucky lollipop that gives you the great one luck? Only 1 cent. Now, that's a steal of a deal there, man. 1 cent for a lucky lollipop that gives you a great one? That's a great deal. Where's this other buck? Is this him? This has to be him. Oh, yeah. That's, is this him? This might not be him. No, this is the one that we messed up. Another big one, though. 91.06. Jeez, man. There's so many big deer around here. That's such a steal. It really is. That is, like, top-notch deals. Here it is. Here's our diamond potential. That guy is... Oh, he's definitely making it, right? That's got to make it. Ah, man. So close. Ah, he's so close. 0.70 off. 0.70 off. Unfortunate, man. It looks like each side's roughly the same. Yeah, it's identical on both sides, so sadly just didn't quite score high enough. It happens, though, guys. It happens. We've seen so many almost diamonds. It happens. At this point, we're used to it. I thought so too, West. I thought so too. Now, something that does happen somewhat commonly with those bigger level 2s like that is it could be one rack below the one that typically makes diamond. But whenever that rack that's like one below diamond has like really good tip-to-tip spread, it usually scores right around that range where it's almost a diamond, but not quite. It happens, though. We shall get a diamond soon, hopefully. Honestly, with the amount of big males we've seen, I wouldn't be surprised if we do see a diamond today, because there's a lot of big 85 to 100 bucks showing up. And honestly, that's how it's been for the last like 400 kills. We've seen lots of big deer, including those two super rares as well. Hey, Hollow, how's it going? Hopefully your day's been going a little better than mine with the Xfinity struggles. Thank you, Thunder. That's going to get us the great one right there. That right there will get us the great one. Let's go main menu so that the deer get back to their zones quicker. And also, so if there's any we forgot, they'll get their respawns as well. We'll see a great one today. I hope so, Kevin. I hope so, man. The Xfinity struggles. What is Xfinity struggles? Internet not wanting to cooperate. That's what it is. How many whitetail am I in right now? In total, over 12,000. For this grind alone, roughly 1,000. Let me actually look at what I've got wrote down. So... oh, actually, we are past 1,000 now. Okay. So we're at about 1,400 kills, actually. I was way off on my estimation. It wasn't 1,000. We're at like 1,400 kills. So it's been like 1,400 kills since our last great one. Jeez. And I'd say probably about 800 or 900 of those are bucks. Man, we gotta be close. We gotta be close, right? Imagine this is him. You know, the fact that I can't spot him, it probably is. Hello. All right, well, we'll spot him later because he doesn't want me to spot him right now. All right, let's take out these since they're actually out in the open. Boop. I wish I could spot you, sir. Just get that guy instead, then. If he's just gonna run in front of us, we might as well. He's hiding? He probably is. He's like, no, please don't shoot me. I have a family. Yep, that's definitely a great one right there. Look at that big male. Told you he was a great one. That lake is my favorite lake. It is a pretty good one. La Hacienda has always been a pretty consistent lake for me. I don't get as many deer here as I did pre-AR update, but I still get quite a few deer at this area. It's still pretty consistent. Oh, it's not shift, canter, it's enter. You hit a left click and then enter. He's a great two, he is. Because he's not number one. He's the great two. The forgotten second place finisher. Yeah, Cheeto, late stream because struggles with internet, as always. Splinter's old internet struggles were passed on to me. Which new hunting game, Cheetah? There's been like a bazillion of them announced and stuff, so... which one are you talking about? Are you talking about Way of the Hunter? Pro Deer Hunting? Are you talking about, Ultimate Hunting? Like, Which one? We got a bunch of them to be looking forward to right now. No, Asher, I didn't. I don't really watch much Call of the Wild content. The one I made a vid on? Is it the unreleased one or the one that I was playing today? I believe the one that I was playing today, Pro Deer Hunting Out West, is on PlayStation. I believe it's just on PS4 and PC. If you're talking about Way of the Hunter, that one will be on all platforms except for Nintendo Switch. And I believe it actually, Way of the Hunter will actually be on PlayStation 4 and Xbox 360, or not 360, Xbox One. It doesn't say it in the trailer because it's, because those aren't like the current generation of consoles. If I'm not mistaken, somebody was mentioning this in my comments that in the fine print of the trailer, it actually does say PS4. So I guess we'll see. In fact, let me look. Maybe not. Let me look. I feel like I heard that it was, but maybe I'm wrong. Okay, so this comment right here says the fine print at the bottom said PS4 and Xbox One, so hopefully it will be available for them as well. So maybe. I don't think they specified though, so I think it's still up in the air as to like whether or not it will be. So it's not confirmed whether or not it'll be available on PlayStation 4 or Xbox One, but it's a possibility that it could be. From what I can tell, I think that's what it is as of now. So it's not guaranteed, but there's a possibility. What game is this, Way of the Hunter? Yes, Way of the Hunter is what we're talking about. Hey, Raider, how's it going? Welcome to the stream. Man, we didn't get rid of that zone, so we gotta go over there and blast those bucks again. Oh, it is on PC. It's on PC as well, Xyphon. It's on PC, PlayStation 5, and Xbox Series, whatever the current letter is. I can never remember the name of the new Xbox. Is it Series X or Series S? Can't remember. But it's on that Xbox, it's on the PlayStation 5, and it's on PC. Nice, Logan. Congrats, dude. That's awesome to hear. They're actually not as strict about it now, Gobbler. YouTube's not quite as strict now with the whole, like, restrictions and stuff being lifted in most areas. They're not quite as strict about it now. Oh, it is X or S. Gotcha. Okay. So I was right with both of them then. Here I thought that one of them was wrong and one was right, but they're actually just different models. No, bad guy. Unfortunately, there is no way to transfer stuff over. S is digital only? Gotcha. Okay. I actually didn't know the Xbox did the digital only version. I knew PlayStation had a digital only one, but I didn't know the Xbox did too. We got a decent amount of bucks over there. I mean, it's nothing like insane, but there is some deer that are bucks. Come on. Nope, no vitals. Sad. What are you? Big male, that's what you are. I just hit her in the toes. Oh gosh. That poor doe. I kind of feel bad now. That poor little doe just got shot in the toe. That's a bar. Really don't know how long I'll stay because it's currently 10:30. Supposed to be asleep. Testing is soon. Oh, no worries, Cheat. If you have to hop off, that's fine, man. Totally understand it. I'm streaming later than I normally would because of those internet problems. It happens. I'm glad that you were able to drop by for a little bit at least. Definitely, Johnny, definitely. I agree with that 100%. It's actually the vitals. Nobody knows it, but that actually is the true vitals of a deer. Hey, Mr. Untamed. How's it going? And no, Asher, I don't. I don't use any exploits in the game. I find it very cheaty to do stuff like that. And if you ask me, that ruins the fun of the game as well. Considering the whole point of Call of the Wild is the actual hunt itself. If you know something's there because somebody else said it was there, then what's the fun in that? That takes away the sole enjoyment of the game. And as you can imagine, as someone who streams and does videos for this game every day, it would not really be fun to do it like that because you want to enjoy what you're doing, and if you take away all the grind, then what would I even have to make content on? The grind is part of the fun for Call of the Wild, for me at least. I know some people like to bypass the whole grinding part, but for me, that's part of the enjoyment. It makes it feel much better when you finally do get the trophy you're after. It was a joke, Z. It was a joke. Where's the best spots for Rocky Elk? To be honest, most of the lakes on Silver Ridge Peaks are good for Rocky Elk. And the thing about it as well is, I think the Rocky Elk can be at most of the lakes on that map. And they move around a lot when you're hunting them as well, so it's kind of hard to pinpoint what's the best spots. Since they move around so often. Alright, later, Thunderman. Thank you for dropping in, dude. Really appreciate you watching. And I hope you have a good rest of your evening. Poor Dill. Didn't see it coming. She thought I was gone. I know for a fact we shot a couple bucks, but I don't know where they went. I would, Wes, but if you have a child of any kind in your videos, then you are subject to a whole bunch of extra guidelines and stuff like that. So I choose not to do that. And to be honest, I don't really want my daughter on the internet. Just because of the amount of, like, weirdos that there are out there. No, Dylan, they don't come with any suppressors. That's just the way the guns sound. There actually is no suppressor on them. And there's no way to put one on them either. There. If we, crouch down, you can see it. It's a muzzle brake. This is the 308 AR, Crystal. It comes in the Modern Rifles pack. Hey, Trippy, how's it going, dude? Glad you can make it. No worries, Defender. Good to see you. Now, where's these bucks? We gotta find them. Hunter, show me the way. Show me the way, buddy. This is definitely not the way. When should the reticle update happen? No news as of now. As of now, there is no announcements as to when we'll get an update. They kind of just told us like what they're currently working on. It can be slightly delayed for people, Hampton. And also, depending on the settings you have on your chat, sometimes it will filter things out. But internet connection is primarily what determines how fast things pop up in the chat and also like where the stream will be. Oh, hold on, guys. Aaliyah just woke up, so I gotta go take care of her for a second. And we're back. All right. Let's go ahead and continue. Now that Aaliyah is downstairs with my wife, now we can continue the stream. Where was that? All right, well, we're not going to get whatever that was. Tolerable at best. Thank you, Mason. Thank you, man. And you didn't miss too much. We got one level 2 that was 0.70 below diamond. As of now, that's the only trophy. Yeah, it's crazy, Caitlin. I didn't know either until, like, a couple seconds ago. Maybe, Cal. I'd say if they were to do, like, any kind of boat or anything along those lines, some type of kayak or John boat or something like that would probably fit best, because I feel like motorboats would just break the game. I feel like they could not do motorboats well at all. So yeah, I'd like to see something along those lines. I knew it, Wacky Bird. I should have known. You know, those sneaky great ones, man, they always walk past you when you're not looking. That's just how it goes. No, Bluefish. She's not. Hey, Gracamella, great one that passed you while you were gone. See? I always miss out. I always miss out on the good trophies. Yeah, Robra. See? You know what's up. It ran over my dog and left? We gotta take it out now. Nobody hurts Hunter. Hunter's my little buddy. Even if he is useless half the time. Silly dog. Nice, Logan. It was a piebald onistic great one. Should have known. You see, like, it's a shape-shifting great one because some people are saying it was a Mela great one. And then you just said it's a piebald onistic great one, so it must be a shape-shifting great one that changes every single time you look at it. That's gotta be it, right? And that was terrible shot on my end. Probably spine. Well, I mean, it'll go down. Terrible shots, but it'll do the trick at least. How's it going, Sam? Yeah, we've got 69 great ones. Have four rare gray foxes trying to get a diamond, finally found 9 legendaries. A troll. Aw, man, Calvin. Unfortunate, man. Honestly, I'd be happy to get a bunch of rare gray fox. I've had great diamond luck with them, but I've only killed one rare. I've got one rare and then like 3 or 4 diamonds. I really want more rares for them though. Because the rare gray fox just looks so nice. Nice, Sam. Oh, also guys, I did get my hands on some more football cards. So there will most likely be a video on the second channel soon opening up a football card mystery box. It was one of the like Walgreens exclusive mystery boxes. So I'm kind of excited to open up this. It could be pretty interesting. I've never opened up the whole mystery box thing, so it'll be interesting to see. NFL football cheetah. It could be pretty interesting though. I've never opened up the mystery boxes from Walgreens, so I'd love to get a hold of like some of the Pokemon mystery boxes, but those things are so hard to get because they sell out almost instantly. Like all of the Targets and Walgreens and stuff like that sell out so fast here. It's honestly crazy how quick things sell out. Yeah, I did see that, Sam. I did see that. I got a Cheddar on notifications, so I see it like immediately when it pops up. I cannot wait till he hurries up and drops things. You know, these next couple months are going to be great for music. We've got Cheddar going to drop his album, hopefully within the next couple months. Rob Banks is dropping an album in a few days. Lil Nar is dropping an album next month. It's going to be good. It's going to be a good couple months for music. Oh my gosh, there were so many more deer up here. I probably should have looked over more before taking my shots. Probably would have been a good idea. Come on. Stop dodging and weaving. Dude. There we go. Okay, beautiful. Perfect. We didn't miss any shots. You guys did not see that. Yeah, Cheetah. That's definitely next level right there. How many supermarkets do you have? I have no idea. I mean, I just moved to this area recently, so still trying to figure out all the stuff that's around here. But so far, there's been like a few places, like, you know, the typical stuff you see pretty much everywhere, like Walmart, Target, Walgreens, like things like that. But like almost all of them are always sold out of sports cards, Pokemon cards, and Magic cards. They all sell out so quickly. You almost have to go there like at the beginning of the day to get anything. Kind of crazy. How did I get this ghillie suit? This one was a special thing for people that purchased the game within the first 30 days of its initial release in 2017 and also had a paid membership on the Hunter Classic active at the time of buying the game. If I'm not mistaken, that was the way that you got it. A supermarket? I don't know. I'm assuming by supermarkets you mean places like Winco, Safeway, things like that, right? And if that's what you mean, I have no idea. I really have not paid attention. I don't even know if we have any around here, Sam. I'd have to look that up. I'd have to check that. Because I'm sure there's probably some places that I'm missing to go look for cards, but we'll figure that out. We'll figure that out soon. I'll do a little more research on places that I can get cards here. Because I would like to find some other places that I can check. Honestly, I think I know why the Walgreens ones sell out so quickly, though. I haven't actually got to see which ones they even have in currently, like which ones are in stock, but the price tags on the empty spots, they say XY, like Pokemon XY series on the price tag. I got a feeling that they've got XY booster packs in right now. Which might be why they're selling out so much quicker than all of the Walmarts in the area. Because if it's XY packs, then there's a chance it's stuff like Evolutions, which is a very expensive booster pack. Along with like a bunch of other XY era packs that are pretty pricey nowadays. So I got a feeling that that's probably what's going on there. Ooh, that shot. Oh my gosh. And I'm proud of it, Bluefish. Believe it or not, I think the Pokemon fan base is primarily adults. And a lot of it's because, you know, most people grew up with it as a kid. And so it's transitioned into their adulthood as well. And part of it's also just the whole, like, collector base behind it, with it as, like, a hobby. The amount of, like, crazy expensive cards there is and stuff that, in most cases, can really only be afforded by adults is kind of crazy. There's so many cards that are ridiculously valuable. Oh, that's a different ghillie suit, Katie. That is the ones for Apex Connect. The one that I'm wearing is a little bit different than those. Want to play Call of the Wild, but like I don't have motivation to get on. Don't enjoy it on the same level. Still love your streams, though. You know what I always do whenever I'm losing interest in something here on Call of the Wild? I create myself like some kind of challenge or goal. And this may be not for everybody, but doing videos on it really helped me keep enjoyment of the game. Because when you're doing videos or streams, you're not only playing the game to play it, right? You're also playing to entertain people. And you're wanting to find new ways that you could make cool videos and like cool content ideas that not only you will enjoy, but everybody else will enjoy. So I do feel like ever since I started doing YouTube, it greatly increased my enjoyment of Call of the Wild because it's no longer just hunting for trophies. There's a lot more to it now. Jeez, Joseph, that's crazy. That's crazy. I'm going to assume that he was probably opening some of the Brilliant Stars packs, right? Because Brilliant Stars has a couple crazy expensive cards. Gotcha, Cheetah. Gotcha. I mean, you can still record stuff on Xbox. It just takes a little bit more, I guess, like extra equipment. Because a lot of times you need a capture card, and then you also need a PC to connect it to that you can do the actual recording from. If you want like super high quality stuff with good audio and things like that. What's an expensive card? Oh, there is an endless list of them for Pokemon. There's so many cards that are worth like hundreds, even thousands of dollars. Some of the really old ones from like the base set. Some of those, if you get them in like perfect 10 condition, they can be worth thousands, tens of thousands. Like, it's kind of ridiculous. If I'm not mistaken, I think the most expensive cards literally have sold in the hundreds of thousands. And I think there might have even been a couple that are worth in the millions, if I'm not mistaken. I think the Illustrator cards that were only given to like a few select people are worth over a million. Could be even more, to be honest. I'm pretty sure recently, I can't remember which one. I don't remember if it was Logan Paul or Jake Paul. I don't really pay attention to them, but one of them was wearing like a graded Illustrator card, and somebody was saying that it's worth like 3.5 million, which is insane. Oh, it is, Joseph? I'm assuming that would be the PSA 10 one, right? The fursuit comes with, what's it called? Medved. You get the fursuit with Medved Rhodes. Come on, come on, come on. Give us a big male. Or does. You know, I'll take some does too. How about that? Why not? Let's just throw some more does in there with our does. Time to take my anger for does out on all the does. Where's the bucks, man? Where's the bucks? Just four does. Oh well, it happens. Who would pay 3.5 million for a card though? Oh, there is a lot of people, Cheetah. It's the same with like any hobby, right? Like there's coins that are worth millions of dollars. There is stamps that are worth millions of dollars. There is football cards that, I don't know if there's any worth millions, but there's football cards that are worth literally tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands. Same for basketball and hockey and baseball. Like no matter what type of card it is, there's going to be a card or two that's worth hundreds of thousands. It's the same with like Magic the Gathering. I forgot the exact name of the card. I think it's the original Black Lotus is worth a few hundred thousand dollars or something crazy like that. I don't know the specific prices, but I know it's worth a crazy amount. And then if you look at stuff like even like Yu-Gi-Oh cards, they have some crazy value for some of the older ones as well. Which is why a lot of times like collecting sealed products for a lot of these sports cards is worth it in the long run. Like I not only open cards, but I also keep sealed ones just to invest in for later, because a lot of these sets in like 10 years they're not going to be in print anymore, and so there's just going to be fewer and fewer of them available as sealed products over the years, and eventually that stuff's going to go up in price. It's one of those things that as long as there is a fan base behind it, and with Pokemon it's such a huge fan base, there's literally millions of people that collect the cards or are at least into it in one way or another. And as long as there's a fan base like that, every set will continue to get opened up and there will continue to be fewer and fewer of them available once they go out of print. Which is why you see a lot of things go up in price like crazy recently. Like just a couple years ago, Pokemon Evolutions booster boxes were just a couple hundred bucks, and now they sell for almost $1,000 for a sealed box. And it's because they're out of print, they no longer make them, and it's a very popular set that a lot of people like. I got a feeling that Brilliant Stars will do the same thing in like 5 or 10 years. Once it stops being printed, I got a feeling that it will hold some crazy value just because of how many good, desirable cards are in the set. It's kind of the same with like Evolving Skies. That set, for the longest time, you could get a booster box for like $100, $110. Now it's almost $200, and that's jumped up to that price in just the last couple months. Crazy how quick it can happen. Hey, Cobb, thank you for the super chat, dude. Really appreciate it. Hope you've been enjoying the stream. Really appreciate the support, man. And you lost me again about boosters. Okay, so boosters are like packs of cards, right? Like a booster pack is like a pack with 10 cards in it. Or 9 or 11. It kind of varies from year to year and set to set. But a booster is like a booster pack of cards. Yeah, I don't think so, Brobra. I don't think Astral Radiance will be as desirable as of a set as Brilliant Stars is. Brilliant Stars has so many like big cards in it that already hold a lot of value just like within the first few months of release. I think we crashed. Oh, nope. Okay. We were just lagging very hard. And there's no deer either. Okay, I think it might be time to go to the main menu again. Nice, Cheetah. Nice, Charles. Just shot an albino bighorn sheep on multiplayer Rancho. That is awesome, dude. Those things are beautiful. I gotta say, that's probably one of the nicer albinos in the game. I really like the albino bighorn. Especially if you can get one that's got like a level 4 horns on it. Those things are beautiful. I don't watch sports anymore, Water Donkey. I used to watch football back in like 2014, but I haven't watched it in years. Kind of just lost interest with the way things were going with it. And from what I hear nowadays, football has become quite a joke with like the referees and the restrictions and the rules that they come up with. Apparently it's got pretty ridiculous, so it sounds like I got out of watching it at a good time. Alright, nothing else over there, so I think we can just go straight to that area. Nice, Pops Pistols, that's awesome. The diamond red deer are gorgeous. Amazing looking animals. Can't even play defense anymore without a penalty. Ooh, oh gosh. The USFL just started last week and it's quite enjoyable. What is USFL? Should have seen the Pro Bowl. Was it just a bunch of grown men hugging? I'm gonna assume that's probably what it is from what I've heard with the rules now. They probably just went out on the field and gave each other some hugs and played catch. They even have helmet cams? Okay, that actually sounds really cool. That actually does sound pretty awesome. I might have to check it out and see how it is. See if I like it. Hey, Blake, you didn't miss anything. Best thing we've got today was a pretty big level 2 whitetail that was 0.70 below diamond. Oh, United States Football League. Okay. Yeah, I'll have to check it out. The Pro Bowl was like one hand touch. Oh, gosh. Oh, gosh. Yeah, it doesn't sound like it would exactly be fun to watch. I mean, let's be honest, half the reason that you watch football is because you want to see the big hits and stuff like that. Nice, Katie, that's awesome. I wish I had got into Pokemon when I was a kid because a lot of those cards nowadays are worth a lot. They even have drones and mics everywhere so you can hear everything going on. Dude, that's crazy. Yeah, I might have to check it out and just see if I like it. That does sound better than the NFL. NFL has got pretty strict from what I've heard. So that might be a good alternative. You never know, it could be the next big thing. Speaking of the next big thing, what do you guys think is going to be the top hunting game at the end of the year? I'm kind of curious what your guys' opinions are, because we've now got three big titles that'll be on the market this year. Obviously, we have Call of the Wild, which is currently one of the best hunting games out. And then we've got Ultimate Hunting that's going to be coming out. And we also have Way of the Hunter. All three of these games are going to provide like a different feel. So what do you guys think is going to be the top hunting game at the end of the year? That's a big deer. And another big deer. Jeez, all the big males are just showing up left and right. Let's head back over here and see if we can get some shots into them. Oh wow, we got quite a mix of different answers here. Call the Wild, Way of the Hunter, Call the Wild, Ultimate Hunting, Call the Wild, Way of the Hunter, Call the Wild, Ultimate Hunting, Call the Wild, Way of the Hunter, Way of the Hunter, Way of the Hunter, Call the Wild, Call the Wild. Yeah, I don't really know. I feel like if Ultimate Hunting delivers on everything they've talked about, it will definitely be right up there with Call of the Wild, but it's hard to say if it will top it, because we still don't know a lot about how the gameplay is going to be. We finally got to see some actual footage of a shot being taken and the animal being shot, and it actually looks decent. They mentioned it was a placeholder sound for the rifle, but the actual like shot and the animations for the animal getting hit and stuff, it actually looks decent. I'll probably do a video on it soon, because it was actually pretty cool, and I feel like a lot of you will probably want to see it if you haven't already. So I probably will cover it, but it looks decent. And then Way of the Hunter, as of now, we don't really know too much about it, except for what I talked about in the video. But I think if Way of the Hunter is an open world hunting game and you can actually keep a trophy lodge of all your trophies that you get in the free hunting mode, I think it'll be very, very competitive in the hunting game genre. And they're gonna have licensed brands. They're gonna have licensed brands of rifles, optics, all that type of stuff. So that alone is going to attract a lot of people. And then if the gameplay is really good, then I think it could be one of the top contenders. It'll probably get delayed. It's hard to say. It is hard to say, man. I hope not. Alright, we got nothing over here. Alright. But yeah, Way of the Hunter is actually going to have massive maps. It's going to be larger than Call of the Wilds. Which is crazy. The maps are going to be giant. Licensed gear, like, it could be amazing. I just hope that it's as good as what I think it will be. I really like the way the deer look. There was a couple things that looked weird, like the mountain goats. The mountain goats did look a little odd, and they never showed us a big elk, so we can't really see like what a big elk would look like. I remember seeing a few people mentioning that the elk looked too small, but I'm gonna guess they probably just didn't show us a big one. Hey, Caden, you really didn't miss too much. We got one decent buck that was close to diamond, but just barely fell short. Oh, definitely, Johnny. And you know what? I'll let them pass on that. Like, I'll give them a pass on some of the animal models if the gameplay is good. Like, if Way of the Hunter provides a immersive experience that's realistic and is fun to play, and if their, like, random antler system is really good, then I'll give them a pass on some of the animals looking a bit weird. Because from what they've said, this game sounds like it's going to be really good. It sounds like it's going to be an amazing game. I just hope it's as good as what they're explaining. Like, one thing that was pointed out to me is that one of the scopes on the rifle in Way of the Hunter is actually a loopholed scope. So we're going to have loopholed optics in the game, or Leopold, or whatever, however you pronounce it. I know some people pronounce it loopholed, but some people pronounce it Leopold or Leopold or whatever. I always say loopholed, but yeah, they've got loopholed optics in the game. So that's going to make Way of the Hunter a contender already. Because that was one of the things people liked about Hunting Sim 2, was the fact that it had real guns and real clothing brands. Nice, Hollow, that's awesome. That's great to hear. It's about time they got it to you. Seems like it took them 10 years. It's a word that's meant to be mispronounced. Probably. Let's be honest, nobody gets a word correct 100% of the time. Well, it's a hit, but it's not a good hit. Sad day. Yes, Water Donkey, it will be on Xbox One. It won't be on Xbox One immediately, though. The plan for Ultimate Hunting is PC release later this year into the Early Access program on Steam. And then once they've finished giving the game all of its updates and it's ready to be fully released to the public, then it will be put onto consoles. So at first it'll only be PC, and then once the game is complete, they will release it to consoles. Yeah, it is Unreal Engine, Glasser. It is Unreal Engine. Caught a 5-pound, 31-inch northern pike last night. Nice, Charles. That's awesome, dude. I wish I could catch pike around here, but Oregon doesn't really have pike at all. When do you think they'll release a new map? Probably June. They tend to release new maps in June and December. So I would imagine June will be the next new map. Alright, Hollow. I'm happy for you. It's nice to see that things are working out. Could be next-gen exclusive. I don't think it will be. Although, by the time it releases to consoles, I think most people will probably be into at least a PS5 or an Xbox Series X. Because in a couple of years, those will go down in price, and the new systems will be out, so... yeah, probably. Hard to say. Will it be on Xbox One or Series XS? I don't know. I really don't know. I haven't talked to Raintech about that. I could message him if you want me to see what consoles it's planned for. I'm assuming that it's probably not known the exact consoles that it'll come to, because they didn't specify last time they mentioned it. They just said that it would be Xbox and PlayStation when they hit full release. I don't think they actually specified which Xbox or PlayStation. No, Pops Pistols, it has not released yet. There is no release date as of now. I was wrong on the release date that I gave in the video, by the way, guys. If you remember, I said December 31st was release of Way of the Hunter, but it seems like that's a placeholder date. Both on Amazon and Steam, they always put December 31st as a placeholder from what I've been told. So, I think it's probably getting released earlier than that. The fact that it says coming soon makes me think that they're probably going to shoot for like a June release. Because if they're smart about it, they'll try to release right before Call of the Wild releases a new map. That would be the smart move to go with. Because almost in any genre of games, or well, in anything really, like in music and game genres, you want to release either on the same day or a little bit before your competitor's release. So I got a feeling Way of the Hunter will probably release their game around the time that Call of the Wild gets a big update. Since Call of the Wild currently is the top hunting game out, that would be my guess. So I'm going to bank on a June release for Way of the Hunter. Could be wrong, but I feel like if they're smart, they'll do a June release. Hunter. Really? Dude. No, you didn't. Bad dog. Just rude. What a rude pupper. Blocking my shots like that. Butt shot. Butt shot. It's actually a decent deer back there. I barely got to see it, but it looked good. Not that one. I saw one that looked decent. Oh, me too, Nate. I've said this a few different times, but even if Ultimate Hunting and Way of the Hunter are both like miles better than Call of the Wild, I'll still play Call of the Wild because not only do I have a lot of you guys that enjoy watching Call of the Wild, but I still enjoy the game. Like, those games being good is not going to change the fact that I enjoy Call of the Wild and I'd still want to play it. And in my opinion, it's just going to be amazing to have multiple hunting games to play instead of only having Call of the Wild and Classic for the most part being like the top games. It'll be nice to see some more options to choose when you want to play a hunting game. And I feel like all of them are going to play a little bit different. It seems like Way of the Hunter is not only going to have the open world kind of Call of the Wild and Classic style hunting, but they're also going to have an in-depth story mode. And from what they've said, they're trying to create the best story mode ever in a hunting game. So I got a feeling that Way of the Hunter is going to have a pretty good place in the hunting genre. And with Ultimate Hunting, it's trying to be the perfect combination of Classic and Call of the Wild. It's trying to be kind of like an in-between level of like realism and arcadiness. I think every game that's coming out next year in the hunting genre is going to fit nicely with Call of the Wild. I don't think any of them are going to beat each other out. I think they're all going to be a little bit different, play a little bit differently, and most people are going to enjoy all of them, I think. Nice, Holo. Let's go. That's awesome. This may be the only time that I've ever seen you use capital letters. That is crazy. Never thought I'd see it in my life. But that's awesome, Holo. That's super awesome to hear. Glad everything's working out for you. How much DLC can I buy with 20 cents? Approximately 0.00000. Yeah, average Joe, that's understandable. The way I see it, though, right, is you can still enjoy Call of the Wild the same amount you do now, and then enjoy the other games just as much. Because like I was saying, I feel like no game will offer the same experience that Call of the Wild does. Call of the Wild is the perfect combination of realistic elements along with a beautiful game. And arcadey, it's arcadey enough to where it keeps you interested because there's always something to do. And I feel like that's Call of the Wild's strong point. It's not so realistic to the point where you have to look 20 minutes to find an animal, but it's also not so arcadey to the point where you just are not even feeling like you're playing a hunting game anymore. It's like the perfect combo, which is why it's a popular game. And I think both of Ultimate Hunting and Way of the Hunter will do quite different things and fit nicely alongside Call of the Wild. Either way, I'm just excited that we're getting new hunting games this year. It's just awesome to see. Because it's, for the longest time, it's been a genre that didn't really get too much love. Like, we had the Cabela's games and the old Deer Hunter games and then, like, a few other companies that tried hunting games. But then in the last, like, 10 years, most companies stopped making hunting games. And the ones that did come out that were not from Expansive Worlds, they really weren't that good. Like, most of the modern hunting games were not that great. Except for Call of the Wild and Classic. So it's just going to be so nice to see more games to choose from. You'll love to see it. But anyway, guys, I think we're probably going to go ahead and end it there. I appreciate all you dropping by. I would have continued the stream for a little bit longer, but I made the mistake of leaving my PC on all day, and now this room is incredibly toasty. But we will be back tomorrow, probably. Wait, what is tomorrow? Let me see. Oh, tomorrow's Monday. Yes, we will be back tomorrow with another stream. And I'm gonna try and get a video out tomorrow. The whole, like, the whole internet being out today kind of threw off my schedule, so I don't know if I'm gonna get a video out on time tomorrow. It might be a little late. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Peace!